Statistics give me anxiety. I'm afraid. Bonjour fragrance lovers, welcome back to my little channel. I hope you're well, I'm well too, thank you very much, blah blah blah, voilà. So, in today's video, I had the idea to tell you what are the best sellers in France, UK and US. Why those countries? Because France is my native country, UK is my adoption country, US, you are my main audience, so you have to be in there. Thank you so much for that as well. I didn't find all the time very accurate results, depend on the sources, it does change all the time, and I'm really bad with statistics and mathematics and things like that, so after hours of research, I was just like, enough! I just took basically what I found, the information of different sources that I find, put them together, have done like a little average. You'll get idea of what fragrances are popular in which country and also what is the trend. Let's talk about France first. What's happening in France? Apparently, the most popular scent in the ladies is La Vie Belle. Always been La Vie Belle since really a long year, since his launch, now it's crazy. It's very that gourmand, ultra sugary scent that ladies love. I think because it's really the ultimate femininity. Then you've got Givenchy, L'Interdit, again, one of the very trendy scents, very round, gourmand, a lot of sweetness for Givenchy, L'Interdit. And then you have J'adore. J'adore is one of the classic, I would say, since I was working in perfumery. J'adore has been one of the scents that was always very popular, very flowery, classic but still modern. And then of course you got Coco Mademoiselle. Coco Mademoiselle is always there. It's the perfect combination of the soft oriental. It's a bit of citrus, a bit of flower and a bit of warmness. So it satisfies a lot of ladies and it really showcases this French timeless elegance without giving too much. The ladies, I would say the trend in France is always been the same to me, like the big designer name. French like to stick to that classic. For a French person, old is gold. They want something that we know, like Chanel, like Guerlain, like Givenchy, Lancôme. These are brands we know and we trust, and this is really what stands out in France. Even though some niche fragrances are going up and up, French really trust their classics. But it's something that you will see a lot, I would say, on all the country, the designer are always the first one, but in France is really something that is in general, like people really stick to the classic. Also, you can really see a ladies for the trend as something very sugary and very flowery. So everything that is gonna be the stereotype of a French, of a very ladylike scent will be very appreciated in France. And then men, first one is Sauvage from Dior, like this really unbroken fragrance, very punchy, I would say very classic, nothing really impressive to me, but very classic, it does work. Jean-Paul Gaultier Le Male, a bit more sensitivity for this one, and Bleu de Chanel for the men. So really scents that are matching a lot of people's taste, they are trendy, they are easy going, and these are fragrances that are ultra versatile. I think for men in France, they in general want to get something that is gonna work for all the situation. Because it's still a minority in France that is having like fragrance for different occasions for men. Men in France in general, when you go to countryside or things like that, like for example in Brittany, that was something really current for us. It's very rare when a male is having like a lot of different fragrance for different occasions. Because they want something that works, they want something trendy, and that's it. And it's really stick to the classic and all this gold again attached to values of the past as well. And I think it's really like our spirit of a little revolution. Like, I mean, we attach to our history very much, and it's still quite a country that is quite conservative in those type of things, like ladylike, gentlemanlike. It really still like this, which I really like. But yeah, since I've went to the UK, I discovered much more like niche brands, really. Let's talk about the US now. I've been to the US, I've been to Portland, which I really enjoy. I love the vibe of it. It's much more compared to my country. I saw everything was much bigger in the US, and people were really a bit like more showing their emotion and things like that. And it was so different, but I really, really enjoyed it, and I wish I could come back very soon. For ladies, I've seen a lot of names coming back, so I've mainly checked on Sephora website and also on Sandbird, because what is growing in the US is thing like Sandbird, where you can actually try different fragrance every month. I would say US seems to be a bit more daring, adventurous. So Flora, Gucci Gorgeous Gardenia, you've got Coco Mademoiselle from Chanel is coming back, Yves Saint Laurent Libre or Black Opium, and you've got again a Chanel Chance Autant. So for ladies, the fragrance seems to be a bit more delicate, so I have scents that are a bit more toned down. I would say light florals, that it seems to be really a trend, and completely opposite side with Black Opium, for example, very spicy. Yeah, you've got really like statement fragrance, that's what I thought. I've seen a Saint from Kat Von D going up a lot. Get a Room by Confession of a Rebel, and I was like, oh, interesting. Angel by Thierry Mugler, a big, big statement. You've got Fantasia by Anna Sui, it's a fragrance that I have as well, beautiful. A Bright Crystal from Versace. Those fragrances, you can find them in a drugstore, so I would say it's really like something that they tend to go for. Like, really, the most popular fragrance are usually quite affordable fragrance, and there's really a big contrast actually, because you can clearly see in numbers that a lot of US people are looking for powerful statement and very high luxurious prestige fragrance. I've seen a lot of Mojave Ghost from Byredo and Santal 33 from Le Labo, for example, so they're looking for something different. What I've seen really that making a big different with friends is that they're not scared of etiquettes. Celebrity fragrance are very popular in US, which is not the case in France. French is always like, oh no, it's quite cheap fragrance, it's not gonna be smelling luxury. But you can really find gems in celebrity fragrance, like Stash, for example. The US market was really, for me, something really open-minded. Open to niche, sick of something prestigious, but not afraid to go to the drugstore and to pick a nice floral scent. And for the men's, I've seen quite the same. I've in France, the biggest names are Sauvage by Dior, Bleu de Chanel, or again, Acqua di Parma, Colonia Pura, that I've seen a lot, and I was like, oh! And that's where it's different. They're not scared of different fragrances, they're going different way, try everything, and I think it's wonderful. Like, it shows really a lot of freedom in the country. I don't know, I quite like that. Whereas France is more strict, US is a bit more discovering things, and it's really nice to see. Now let's talk about the UK. God save the Queen. For the UK, I've got a little number. I actually don't wear glasses, it's just for the style. 55% of women prefer woodier and spicier. And there's a boom of unisex fragrance in the UK. Yes, well done. It's really like gender-free country, which is so nice. And that's why I love to live in London, because I love the fact that ladies are not scared of anything different. And you can really see it by the top of UK scent. I've seen a lot of fragrance like Tom Ford, Black Orchid coming back. Coco Mademoiselle, of course, was always here. Jo Malone, Oud & Bergamot, Dolce & Gabbana, L'Impératrice, that is very popular here. The men's side, I could see Calvin Klein, CK1, Buzz But All Night, Jupe Homme, Jupe, of course, like it's a classic for me. I don't know a single man in the UK that doesn't know this fragrance, and Davidoff Cool Water. So really, for the men, I felt something, they like something like quite like, I would say, bomb, like quite like beast mode, as US would say, but in a burst of freshness. I think like this is really something I've seen a lot. They love that really aftershave beast freshness, and I think that really showed the gentleman type of vibe that is going on in the UK. They like something that is like fresh, smell clean, and really gives like a lot of projection like this, which is nice. And again, like for the men, really not scared of unisex. When you see that the first fragrance sold in the UK is Calvin Klein CK1, which is a unisex fragrance, it shows a lot about the trend in UK. And this is really what I like, because it leaves the space of a niche fragrance or small houses to grow. You can see that during the three countries, there's really like big differences. Well, in the trends, UK gender free, like going unisex and voilà, blah blah blah. US, you get really like something they stick to good values but want to explore prestige and go to different type of place, is very open-minded to shop their fragrance. And in France, it's the perfumery rules, meaning you go to your department store, you get, you design the scent, and that's it. I'm joking, of course, there's a lot of niche going on in France as well, but this is really what you can see in general. So bear in mind that this is generality statistic, it doesn't show your reality or mine. Like, as fragrance lover, I'm interested in everything. If we want to talk globally about the fragrance market, there's a few trends coming on, meaning the race for prestige. We're really looking for something different now, unique, very prestigious, really unique, and this is really a big trend nowadays. Something immersive, we've seen a lot of explosion of something really, we're looking for an immersive experience, going to a store and leave an experience that's going to make us feel the fragrance. And this is really a big trend as well, and this is why you can see unisex and niche fragrance booming, because they offer you an experience. Like when you go to the store, they will tell you how to leave the fragrance, and this is very great, and I wish I could see that more often, especially for designers. And there's also a big trend that I didn't talk about, is low waste luxury. We're looking for something that is going to be more ethic, ecologic as well, and you can really see a trend on that. And then you can really see the trend that I personally prefer, is the gentle fluidity future. Like you can really see that, I think in a few years, maybe not in 10 years or something, but in a few years coming, fragrance will go into something not marketing for men and for women. For me, there's going to be a boom of, this is just a fragrance, and it's not because it's woody and spicy that you ladies can't wear it. Right, I hope you enjoyed the little insight into some statistic and how the trends looks like nowadays. I think it's going pretty well, and I'm pretty proud of the fragrance community and where it's going to, and I can't wait to see the change in the future. Tell me maybe, how do you think this is going to go? And what do you think about the difference between the country? And what is your main difference with your own country as well? I mean, like, I've got followers from different countries, and I'm sure you do have like a main difference as well in your country. So share it with us in the comments. You can support me on my YouTube account in the description box. You can watch free ads to support me. You can also follow me, leave me a little like, and watch my other video if you want to, and I will see you very soon. Bye now.